In the words of the Mahatma, earth has enough for man's need, but not enough for man's greed. And to paraphrase the words of Konrad Adenauer in his last brilliant speech to the German parliament, he said, God has placed limits on man's reason, but on his stupidity he has not. When we speak of universal values and ethics, I would like to say that universal is an endearing term because, after all, there is nothing culturally global about globalization. It is more about economics and government and politics than it is about specifically the issues of the moment, climate change, which we could describe as ecology, the question of man against man in this continuing sociological imbalance that exists between rich and poor and between ethnicities on the one side and cultural anthropology on the other, in addition to, of course, the ever-present question of migration. I personally am involved to a very large degree with the world refugee and migration problem and have been for decades, and I see it as self-perpetuating and growing a problem, both in numbers and in quality of life. So I would like to suggest to the participants in this conversation that the centrality of human dignity, or dignism, as Evelyn Linda has termed it, along with Linda Hartling, the concept of a university of dignity, is one way of networking the cultural values that we seek. Of course, I have been very keen to remind those who are working with the infosphere and the terrorsphere, which seems to be taking so much of the time of the modern media of communication and Facebook, etc., that we simply have to bear in mind that our essential quality is cogens, the ability to reflect and meditate wisdom in brief. And so I suggested that maybe we should add a cogitosphere, an ability to think across continents and to develop a route of ideas. We have a Silk Route, we have a Spice Route, we have several pilgrimage routes. But when will ideas develop a template of common understanding of how we promote humankind and humankind's values in relation to ecology on the one side and society on the other side? I think that what is important is that we do not take sides, that we try to develop a middle ground and to develop through comprehension an understanding of this all-important struggle to win the human race, win in terms of the time that we do not have, win in terms of the future generations and respect for their lives, which surely can commit us. And if some of us feel that we are too old or too young, please remember the initiatives such as Generations United, and indeed the words of Mary Catherine Bateson, who talks about second adulthood. I believe that this second adulthood is profitably spent in proactively reaching out to others and talking to others and developing a very real understanding in compassion and love for each other, as indeed the recent papal encyclical Fratelli Tutti emphasized. We are, after all children of this universe. And the time has come to ensure that in this 21st century that the future does not look too much like the darker sides of our past. All the very best to you, and thank you for inviting me.